In this tutorial, I'm going to describe how you can capture some video specifically for tracking to be able to use and save as a motion path. So in this case, I have a thread that I've attached a little piece of pipe to over a black background. And I want to capture that natural swinging effect. You see how it eases in with nature, that sort of thing, using gravity and all the things that come naturally to this world. So I want to basically, instead of doing that manually and setting it up manually, I want to basically track a natural object and then use that track in a title in the future. First thing I do is select the clip and then click on the track motion button. As soon as you see the track motion button come up, I go in here and I grab the crosshairs and I place them where I want to track this clip. It has a match object here, so I'll turn that off. I'll rename my tracker. And then I'm ready to go. I'll just hit record. Now what's it going to do is it's going to track that pipe. You can see the tracker's following it as it's moving through the tracking phase. Percentage, of course, being shown in the top right of progress. VideoStudio Pro X6 is very fast when it comes to tracking. And there we're done. You can see the tracker, if I scrub through here, you can see the tracker following around. If I turn the tracking path off, you can see here that red dot is following quite well on this piece of pipe. I'll say OK. So now this clip has a track information onto it. So if I go back in here and I right click on it and I go back to track motion, you can see that I can add a number of trackers to this. I could add another tracker to the bottom of the pipe. I could add trackers basically anywhere I want. So here I want to do is I want to be able to save this particular tracker that's selected. If I had a number, I could select each one individually. I can go in here and select this pipe tracker, and there's a little arrow here that says Save Path to Library. So it's going to ask me which library I want to save it to. So custom. I can, if I had a number of trackers here at the same time, I could export all of them, all the visible paths, to the path library. So I'll save it to the custom path library. Say OK. And it tells me export is successful. Now I have this clip with the track. Let me just delete it from the timeline. And let's add a title. So I'll just double click in the title area. Very, very simple project. And I'm going to just type in a title here called Swing. Let's change some of the parameters on this title. I'm going to change the color, make it white so it's easy to see. I'll go back to my transparency and set it. So there I have a very simple title. Just go put it in the middle of the screen using the alignment tool. Okay, so if I had a video underneath this right now, what would happen is the title would just sort of be on screen and then leave the screen. But now with VideoStudio Pro X6, you have a new library called the Path Library. So X6 comes with a number of pre-programmed paths. These paths were generated. You can use them on your titles if you want. You can just drag them onto a title like this and then hit play. And you'll notice now the title is following that path. But as I showed you, you can track other objects in your own videos or your own sets to be able to add your own paths. So let's select that swing again, go back into the path library, and you'll notice now the path that I had saved is in custom. You see swinging back and forth really fast. I drag that to my title, and now I can hit play, and you'll notice now it's swinging. If I go in here and I stretch it out, the swing slows. The wonderful thing about using this particular function is that you can bring in real-life movements into your video productions without having to have a lot of complexity in terms of setting up keyframes and bias and movement and Bezier splines and that sort of thing. You can just go make a set of a bouncing ball, this swinging pipe as in this case, or a pedal being turned, and be able to capture that path and then use it in your video productions by attaching it to other objects. This could just as easily be a video. So let's grab a video and put the swing path onto the video. So I'm going to my video clips, drop this clip into my overlay track, and you'll notice that it's scaled. Go into my path library, select that path, and now you're going to notice that my video is swinging. So that's a very good way of being able to use object tracking and saving the path into your path library, and then using it in the future to be able to make really, really wonderful effects and motions and animations for all of your titles, graphics, and videos.